Yeah, welcome to social studies class for GSS 1. The topic we are looking at today is social problem, and we are focusing on examination malpractice. Social problems include armed robbery, it includes corruption and the like, just as we discussed last time. This time, we are focusing on examination malpractice. It's also a social issue. Before we proceed, let us look at the learning outcomes. By the end of this lesson, it is expected that students should be able to explain the meaning of examination malpractice. That is one. Two, students should be able to mention at least three causes of examination malpractice. Three, students should be able to state at least three effects of examination malpractice. What is examination malpractice? Examination malpractice is any form of misconduct or offense in the process of writing an examination. We have all written examination at this level, we have written one or two examinations, even before you get to SS. And to this GSS 1 class, you have written examination in your primary school. You have even written examination in our school before. So any form of misconduct, any irregularity that is an offense, and it is done deliberately in the place of writing examination, is called examination malpractice. As I say, that it's a deliberate wrong doing. It is contrary to official examination rules designed to place a candidate at the unfair advantage or disadvantage. This social problem can be done in collaboration with fellow students, parents, teachers, supervisors, educators, and any other group. Examination malpractice involves appointment of choice of invigilators. It involves copying and cheating someone else's work. It also includes refusing to submit when the invigilator has asked for the script. Impersonation is also a form of examination malpractice, just to mention a few. We are going to look at the next subheading now, which is causes of examination malpractice. The first one we have is inadequate preparation on the part of the student. The student did not prepare for examination, you will definitely not perform well. In order to ensure you pass the examination, you want to involve examination practice, and this is one of the causes. That because he did not prepare very well. He did not study notes, he was supposed to study notes, he may have skipped class, and he may not have consulted good textbooks. Let us move to number two cause of examination practice. Lack of good learning environment is another cause of examination malpractice. If environment is a great factor in teaching and learning, if environment is not conducive for teaching, the student may not assimilate better, may not understand the topic better, and when examination comes, this lack of good learning condition will make the student to want to involve in examination malpractice. The third we are going to see is poor societal and parental orientation. Our society today, I believe that just go and pass examination. The process on how you pass examination does not matter. Even parents who have lost students, once you pass examination, they will not want to find out if you involved in examination malpractice or not. And even some parents have put in money, paying bribe to ensure that students Their teachers assist them in writing the examination. Also, we have a voluminous syllabus in certain subjects. If a subject is too voluminous, students may find it difficult to comprehend and write the examination without any form of malpractice. We also have here, number 5, bribery and corruption on the part of the examination repetitor and supervisors. These invitators and supervisors that are supposed to ensure that the hall of writing the examination is free from malpractice are also involved in bribery and corruption, as they accept money from parents and students to ensure the student pass the examination even with malpractice. We are going to move to effects, that is, the problems that will be caused by examination malpractice to us as a nation. So we are looking at the effect of examination malpractice. Examination malpractice discourages hard work and diligence, number one. Someone that is hardworking and diligent at work, who have written an examination and you not have good grade, and he sees another person who did not do any hard work at all and excel, we may want to trade on that path to continue to evolve in examination and practice. We want to join people that involve in examination and practice. Number two, it decreases job efficiency, that is, inability to perform to expectation at work. The essence of examination is to measure ability. And once you have done, once the examiner has said that you have done well in an examination and you have a good grade, employers of labor, we believe or we have the expectation that you can perform at that level. And when they are giving that job and you didn't meet up to the expectation, it decreases job efficiency, and that is the ability to perform to expectation at work. We still have other ones, effect of examination malpractice, which will be seen in your notes. Meanwhile, let's quickly move to the assignment. Students are expected to explain in an assignment. Explain an examination hall that be free of examination malpractice. The whole of this question is simply saying that it should provide solution to examination malpractice. Thank you very much.